And today in the studio, there's none other than my friend and yours, Michelle Rice. How you doing, Michelle?
Doing wonderful today. This is the day that the Lord hath made, and we are going to rejoice and be glad in it. And I am your sister in Christ, Michelle Rice, and you have just logged on to the Prayer Connection, where you make a connection with God. Yes, you've just logged on to the Prayer Connection, where you make a connection with heaven. And on today, I always, always like to give you a little prayer nugget to help you in your intercessions, help you in your prayers, help you in your petitions towards God. And today's prayer nugget is located right in Luke 11:1. Let us read. And it came to pass that as he was praying, talking about Jesus, in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray, as John also taught his disciples. And it came to pass that as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray, as John also taught his disciples. See, we see the text says the disciple asked him to teach us to pray. He didn't say teach us how to pray. Sometimes we want to be a deep wonder. We want to know everything about all the mechanics of prayer. All we want to know about prophetic intercession. It's okay to know a lot, but sometimes you don't know need to know a lot. But sometimes we want to know what is the prophetic intercession. I want to know about what's the prayer consecration, what's the prayer petition, what's the prayer intercession. And all these things are good to learn and know. But initially, just teach me to pray. In other words, get me in the habit of praying. The disciples watched Jesus pray, and he was looking at Jesus' example and said, you know what? That's how we need to be. Teach us to pray. Get us in the habit of praying. Give us a spirit of prayer. Teach us how to pray without ceasing. The Bible says in Luke 18, men ought always to pray and not to faint. Teach us to pray. So he's saying, praying and not fainting. Tells us what to do, pray, and what not to do, don't faint. In other words, God wants us in these last days to get into a habit of praying. I mean, we shouldn't just have just praise on Sunday morning. We don't want to be a Sunday morning prayer warrior. We want to be a prayer warrior each and every day. We want to get in the habit of praying. We want to know what it means to pray without ceasing. We want to know what it means to pray in the morning, pray in the noonday, pray when the sun goes down. Pray, pray, pray on the good days. Pray on bad days. Pray in the situations of life. Pray for your family. Pray for your church. Pray for leadership. Pray for the president. Just teach us to pray. Get us in the habit of praying. And then after all that's done, then we can get into the mechanics of prayer. But initially, teach us to pray. Get us in the habit of praying, Father, in the name of Jesus. Now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, as we come to you today, Lord God, we ask you today, God, everybody is praying today, Lord God, all over the airways, God, everybody in the city, in the state, God, and oh, God, people across the borders, God, people across the waters, God, oh, Father God, in the name of Jesus, somebody all over the nation, God, we ask you today, God, teach us to pray. God, it's imperative that we get in the habit of praying. It's imperative, God, that we get in the nature of praying. And without ceasing, God, for there's so many things going on in the land, so many things going on in our city, so many things going on in the nation, God. It's so much going on. So, Father God, teach us to pray, Father. And when we come to you to pray, God, we first of all have to ask you to forgive us of our sins, God. Cleanse us from all unrighteousness, oh God. Father God, we know when we come to you, God, we gotta come clean. Father God, we ask you to purge us, oh God. We ask you to cleanse us, oh God. We ask you to wash us, oh God. We ask you to purify our hearts, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Father God, your word says, if my people who are called by my name, if they just humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, you said, I will hear from heaven. I'll forgive their sin and I will heal the land. And then you said your eyes will be open and your ears attentive to the prayer that is made into this place. In the name of Jesus. Father God, you said, Lord God, who shall ascend into the hills of the Lord and who shall stand in this holy place? But that man, that woman, they got clean hands and a pure heart, who have not lifted up their soul into vanity nor sworn deceitfully. You said that man shall see the Lord. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Father God, when we come to you, Lord God, we kind of always got to come clean. We want a clean slate, God, that we can enter into prayer. We can enter into intercession. We can enter in, Lord God, to petitions and supplications, God. We can begin to pray for our families. Pray for the nation, God. Pray for all those around us in the name of Jesus. Now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, sometimes when we pray, God, we don't know all what to pray for as we ought to. So we asking for a spirit of discernment, God. We asking for discernment, God. Show us what to pray. Teach us what to pray. Show us the hidden things, God. Show us the hidden things, God, that need to be revealed. Need to be revealed in our churches. Need to be revealed in the land. Need to be revealed in our homes, in our country, oh God. Show us the hidden things. Father God, that comes from the spirit of discernment. Father God, we praying for discernment today. Father God, sometimes we don't know what to pray for as we ought. So we have to rely on the Holy Ghost. It's the Holy Ghost that gives us discernment. It's the Holy Ghost that prays the perfect prayer. Oh God, we relying on the Holy Ghost today. We relying on the third person of the Godhead. We relying on the Holy Spirit, oh God, to come in the midst of us and to be the lead intercessor. Father God, I'm not trying to act like I know how to pray. Oh God, that because I have prayed, that don't mean I know what to pray now. It's a new day. It's a new situation. It's new circumstances. It's new problems, God. It's new things going on. So I can't rely on yesterday's prayer. I can't rely on last week's prayer. I can't rely on last year's prayer. I got to pray today. Today is the day of salvation. I got to pray today. I got to know what's on your mind today, God. I got to know what, God, what you want me to pray for today. And Father God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Rosh Hananamakia no Roskata. Nanamasia no 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 kosatana na kandirilobose. Ya no 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 kosatana mashia. We need the Holy Ghost right now. Father God, I pray right now in the name of Jesus. You dropped in my heart. Oh God, as we have prayed through January, God, and everybody was fasting and praying and seeking your face, God. Father God, I pray right now, God. You said, Lord God, like you told Daniel, you said the first time you prayed, the first day that you prayed, you said, I heard your prayers. But you said, Lord God, that there was a principality. It was a prince of Persia. And the prince of Grecia, he came to fight against Daniel. But God, you heard Daniel the first day. He fasted 21 days. But Father God, on the first day, you said, I heard your prayers. On the first day, you said, I heard your intercession. On the first day, I heard your all your supplications. On the first day. So Father God, I thank you, Lord God. As we start the month off praying, God, you said, you know, you didn't wait till now to answer us. You said, you heard us the first day, but God, we had to persevere in prayer. Sometimes, God, we got to press towards the mark for the high calling of God in Jesus Christ. Father, we got to press our way in the name of Jesus. And when we come to pray, Lord God, we got to press into a praise. We have to give you your just due, God. We got to say glory, hallelujah. We got to praise your holy name, God. We have to give you glory, oh God. We have to acknowledge you, Lord God. We have to acknowledge the Holy Spirit. We have to acknowledge you, oh God. We have to give you the glory that's due unto your name. We got to praise you in the morning, God. Praise you in the noonday, God. Praise you when the sun goes down. Father God, we thank you, Lord God. One of the best prayers is the prayer of worship. One of the best prayers is the prayer of praise, because it acknowledges God. You said, trust in the Lord and lean not to your own understanding. And all your ways acknowledge God, and you will direct our path. So we come to you, Lord God, in initially in the first of our prayers, after we have cleansed ourselves, after we have washed, been cleansed by the Spirit of the living God, then we enter into praise. You said, enter into my gates with thanksgiving and into my courts with praise. You said, be thankful unto me and bless my name, for you are good, O God. And your mercy is everlasting, and your truth endureth to all generations. So God, when we first start off the prayer, after we get clean, God, hallelujah, after we wash, we got to praise you. Because we shouldn't come in asking you, God, for all kinds of stuff and all kinds of petitions and all kinds of requests that we didn't even acknowledge you. How do we acknowledge you, Father? We acknowledge you through our praise. Hallelujah, we praise you. You said, in all things give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. We come in saying, thank you, Lord God. We come and saying praise your holy name. We come and saying glory, hallelujah. We say, Lord God, you are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be thanked. You are worthy to be worshipped. You are worthy, Lord God. We serve a worthy God, hallelujah. We serve a God that answers prayers. We thank you, Lord God, for your faithfulness today. We glorify you, Father God. Sometimes we don't need even action for nothing. Lord God, as long as we get into that praise, oh God. You said when praises go up, blessings come down, God. In the name of Jesus, Father God, you said praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and harp. Praise him with the timbreland dance. You said with everything, they got breath, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, we give you praise. Praise is due you, God. Father God, if I work all week long and I work for 40 hours, a paycheck is due me. Because I'll work 40 hours. But God, how much should we praise you at all times? Praise is due you. Father God, you always working for us. You work, you always showing off for us. You always raising up your sleeve and working for us, God. So we praise is due you. We're not giving you nothing that's not due you. Praise is due you. Worship is due you. You said worship me in spirit and in truth. For you seek such to worship you. Father God, we thank you, Lord God, for a spirit of prayer. We thank you, Lord God, for a spirit of praise, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that we can come to you and say thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for everything you've done for us. Thank you for our families. Thank you for our churches. Thank you for supplying all of our need according to your riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Thank you for the peace that surpasses all understanding. Thank you for the joy of the Lord, which is our strength today, God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, that you have let us live another day. We thank you, Lord God, that we are living. We are now in the land of the living. Father God, somebody didn't make it last year. I know two people, best close people in my life, in my church. They died, by the way, God. They went on to glory, God. But since you kept me here, Lord, you kept me here for a purpose, God. If we're still here, we're here for a purpose, God. We're not here to just meander around and be up to nothing. God, if you kept us here, there's a reason why you kept us here. There's purpose on our lives, oh God. I'm praying for everybody that's listening, praying with me. Father God, we thank you, oh God, for purpose. There's purpose on our lives, oh God. There's a reason why we keep exhaling and inhaling, taking in oxygen and breathing out. It's a reason why we didn't hit the grave. It's a reason why we still on this side of eternity. It's a reason why we're not pushing up daisies. It's a reason why, oh God. So I'm praying right now in the name of Jesus. Father God, in this year, in 2016, we want to know the purpose. We want to know the reason why we're living. We're not living just to make a buck. Oh, go to work, come back home. Go to work, come back home. Go to work, come back home. It's more to life than going to work and coming back home. Oh, God, it's more to this than me making money. Father God, it's a reason. It's a spiritual reason. Father God, I'm praying today for everybody that's listening, every saint. Let no saint be left behind. I'm praying today, Lord God, that their purpose, oh God, they'll come to know the reason why you put them on the planet, the reason why they're still living. Oh God, I know, God, we got purpose today. We have a reason. Oh God, there's a reason for our existence. It's a reason why we're breathing. It's a reason. It's a reason. Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, so I'm praying for the destiny of your people, though God, that I pray right now in the name of Jesus. Oh God, that destiny will be revealed, that which is hidden, God, reveal it. Show us today. Show us our call. Show us our purpose, oh God. Begin to reveal our gifts. You said a man's gifts will make room for him and bring him before great men. Father God, reveal the gifts today, oh God. Reveal our purpose, oh God. Reveal the destiny, oh God. Our Father God, that people got a cause on their lives. Somebody listening over in the Asia today. They got a reason. They got purpose. You might be in Detroit, Michigan, but you got purpose today. I don't know. You might live in Cleveland, Ohio. My God wants you to know you got purpose today. You got purpose. Oh, yes, yes, yes. You might be in New Zealand today. You got purpose on your life. It's a reason why that car wreck. You didn't die in that car wreck. You could have died. You could have been dead right now. But God let you survive that car wreck. You got purpose. So we need to cry to God. Show us a purpose. We want to know, God. I know, God. You say ask, and it shall be given unto you. Seeking, ye shall find. Knocking, it shall be open unto you, God. You said, every ask we can receive. So, God, I'm praying today all over the land. You said you work all things together for our good, for those who love the Lord, for those who are called according to his purpose. In the name of Jesus, young girl. God, you're only 12 years old. I'm letting you know you got purpose today. You're not going to be like everybody else in your class. You're not going to be like everybody else in your school. You got purpose. Don't try to fit into nobody. Don't try to fit into the crowd. Don't try to fit into the most popular people. You just be do yourself and you be you. You got a purpose today. God's calling you today in the name of Jesus. You might be the older gentlemen, I know you hitting 89 today. Your birthday is today. You turned 89, but God is letting you know today. That don't mean you don't have no purpose. You got a reason why you're still here. You have a reason why you hit that 89th mark, and God is not done with you yet. Just because you're older, that does not mean God is done with you. As long as you got breath in your body, you got something to do. Hallelujah. Then you need to get on your knees. And you say, well, I'm too old to get on my knees. But you call out to God and you ask God in this season, in this last beginning of the month, in the beginning of the year, in January and February, it's 2 months. It's a consecration time. It's time of consecration in the name of Jesus. It's time to consecrate ourselves and get our lives in order. The Bible says, somebody told me at the first, it determines the rest. If you get the things done in the beginning of the year, oh God, your year will go smoothly. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father God, I pray right now, God. I pray for those high school students. Oh God, and they get ready to go into college in the fall coming up. Father God, give them the reason why they're here on the earth. And show them what you want them to do. Don't let them take a course. Don't take a major, oh God. And don't and just taking it because somebody told us that's a good job to take. That's a good field to go in. Let them go in the field that's according to their purpose. Let them go into the college field that's according to their destiny. So we won't be wasting time. We ain't got time to waste. A lot of us are over the 50 mark, the 50-year-old mark. We right in the middle. Oh God, we can't waste the next half of our lives. I'm praying for everybody that's 50 and older, right in that middle, that middle ground. I'm praying today, God, that you will show us, God. We won't waste the next half of our life. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, the book of Joel said, restore unto us the years that the canker worm and the caterpillar has stolen from us. Somebody said, I feel like I've wasted time. I feel like I've wasted a lot of years. I feel like I've wasted a lot of good strength in my life. But God, I hear you saying, that's all right. We got the second half to go. I pray today that we will not die prematurely. In the name of Jesus, I come against premature death. I come against the spirit that will try to take us out before our time. In the name of Jesus, we will not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, Father God, I pray today. Right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Rashana Namakia no kosa. Ya no kosa tananashia no kosa tananashete. Father God, I pray, Lord God, that every gift that's lying dormant in your people. God, you've given us all kinds of gifts. Some people have gifts of speaking, gifts of dance, gifts of preaching. Oh God, many are evangelists and prophets and teachers and evangelists and apostles, but they don't even know who they are yet. I'm praying this year, God, you reveal to them who they really are. God, you're not who their friends told them they were. You're not who your friends told you you were. You're not what the haters told you you were. You're not even what your mama told you were. She could have said things about you and shaped your life, and it wasn't even the words of God. All that negativity has followed you. Oh God, I pray right now, God, that cause them to shake off the negativity. Oh God, somebody said, you know, God, when I was growing up, I didn't have any encouragement. Nobody showed me the way. Nobody taught me. Nobody poured into me. Nobody showed me what my gifts were. Nobody helped me shape my life. But God is saying, it's all right. It's not too late because you have to follow God now. And God said, you're supposed to rely on him, to trust in him and lean not to our own understanding. And all our ways, acknowledge him, he will direct you. God's going to shape your life from this day forward. He's going to pour into you. He's going to pour into you your talents. Pour into you your anointings. Pour into you your giftings. Pour into you. This is a season of pouring into in the name of Jesus. My Father God, I thank you for anointing us afresh to do the will of the Lord. Father God, you said on earth as it is in heaven. Father God, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Everything you got in your mind for us, God, we want to do it. We want to complete our assignment. We have an assignment. We're not just here to take up space. We're not here to take up room. We all have an assignment. I have an assignment. You have an assignment. She has an assignment. And he has an assignment. We all got assignments. I'm praying, Lord God, you will show us our assignment. I pray for every church. Every church has an assignment to the country, to the city, to the nation, to their state. Every church has an assignment. Father God, I pray, God, you reveal the assignment to each church. Each individual church has an assignment. So I'm praying today, God, in the name of Jesus, that every church will fulfill their assignment on the planet, oh God, in the name of. We all supposed to win souls, but there is a specific assignment for each church. It's a specific assignment for each family. It's a specific assignment for each person. So God, we say reveal. Oh God, you say we reveal. You reveal to us that what is hidden, oh God. You will reveal to us that what is concealed in the name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. Father God, we give you praise. Father God, we give you glory, oh God. We give you honor, oh God. We pray, oh God, for every marriage. You reveal to them the reason why you put the two together. Father God, we wasn't put together just to be put together. The husband and the wife weren't put together because one thought one was cute and the other one thought the other one was handsome. That's not the purpose. It's purpose for marriage. Yes, there's benefits, but there's a purpose why you put two people together. There's an assignment for each marriage. Just like there's an assignment for the church, for each church, and an assignment for each family. There's a sign for each marriage. Show them why they were put together. They could have been why they were joined together. Why they were made one flesh. Why they became one being. It's a reason. So Father God, today I thank you for the reasons. Oh, you revealing us the reasons, God. Hallelujah. Oh, praise your Lord God. We thank you, Lord. When it's all with this 2016 going to be a great year, because God, we're going to start walking into purpose. We're going to start living on purpose. We're not going to get up and meander around. We're going to get up with purpose. We're going to preach with purpose. We're going to live with purpose. We're going to do our jobs with purpose. We're going to do everything with it's a purpose. So we thank you for that right now, Father. In the name of Jesus. And oh God, one of your purposes is for every man, every woman to come to know who Jesus Christ is. Father God, I pray today, God, that everyone that's listening today, okay, it's a reason, it's a purpose why they logged on. They didn't just happen to, by half chance, logged on to KAZ Radio, the inspiration station of the nation. They didn't just perchance happen to be looking at the it didn't just pop up on their phone. It didn't just pop up on their laptop. You designed it, Lord God. So if they logged on today, God, it's a reason. And Father God, if they don't know you as their personal Savior, if they don't know you as their Lord and Savior, Father God, today you want to let them know their purpose. Without Jesus Christ, we will never know our purpose. Jesus Christ in us, the hope of glory. Jesus Christ is our He reveals purpose. Without Jesus Christ, you would never know your purpose. Without Jesus Christ, you would never know what gift you have, what call you have. Without Jesus Christ, you would never know your assignment. Without Jesus Christ, you are hopeless. Without Jesus Christ, it's useless living without Jesus Christ. So today, God, I'm calling all over the land, God, everybody that's listening, God, that don't know Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, I'm praying today that they will come to know Jesus, oh God. They will call upon your name, God. You said, whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. In this time, oh God. Okay, these are the last days, and it's the end time harvest. So I'm calling everybody that don't know Jesus. Somebody, I know you want Jesus. I know you want to touch the Savior. So you have to reach out and call upon his name. Oh God, you said in your word, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart that God has raised it from the dead, you will be saved. With your heart, you believe it, and with your mouth, you confess it. Hallelujah. It's a simple thing today. Father God, that's how you start off. That's how you start the year off right. That's how you start the year, coming to know Jesus so you can begin to live. Because if you don't know Jesus Christ, you're not living, you're existing. You're just existing. You're just breathing and existing. But when you come to know Jesus, you will come to know your purpose. So repeat after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I realize that I'm a sinner in need of a Savior. Come into my heart. You said if I confess my sins, you'd be faithful and just to forgive me. Father God, I thank you right now that I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus, and I believe in my heart that God has raised him from the dead. Your word says, I am saved. I am saved. So, Father God, I thank you that somebody prayed that prayer. If only one person prayed that prayer, this broadcast was worth it. If only one person prayed that prayer, it makes KAZ useful. It only takes one. It's one soul is worth it. Jesus left the 99 and went after that one. He left the 99 and went after the one. So every time we come together on KAZ Radio, every time we come together on the Praise Zone, we going after that one. Now, if we get a million, praise God for the million souls. But today, I'm looking for the one. I'm looking for the one that's about to commit suicide. Because they say, what's the use? What's the use of living another year like I lived last year and the year before and the year before? Father God is saying, you don't have to take your life. God said, I will give you life. Don't take your life. Receive life today. Hallelujah. When you prayed that prayer, the hope of Christ came in you today. The hope of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the hope of glory. No need to take your life today because you have received life. Jesus says, I am the resurrection and the life. Jesus come to give us life and life more abundantly in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, Father, we thank you, Lord, and we praise you. Hallelujah. Somebody got saved. Now, if you got saved today, just don't leave it like that. It's something you got to do. You accept Jesus Christ, your personal Savior. That's good. Whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord is saved. That's good. But something you got to do. Remember we talked about in the beginning, teach us to pray. The disciple says, Lord, teach us to pray. That's what you got to do. You got to get in the habit of praying. What is praying? Talking to God. Just talking to God. You don't got to be a deep wonder. Oh, God, most gracious, high up in the heavens, you're lifted up. No. Just talk. Like you talk to your friend, like you talk to your coworker. Talk to God. Share things with him. So after you're praying to God, then you got to get in his word. I encourage you, start reading the book of John. Read that book over and over and over. That means you're getting spiritual food. You're learning who this Jesus is. You're learning who your Savior is. You're learning who your God is. You're learning this friend that's sticking closer than a brother. So you're praying, you're reading your word, and then ask God, lead me to a good church. You need to be around other believers. You can't do this thing on your own. No man is an island. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, and we praise you. Now, I will see you next time on the Prayer Connection, where you make a connection with God. I will see you next time on the Prayer Connection, where you make a connection with heaven. And I'm your sister in Christ, Michelle Rice, saying I love you. May God bless you and keep you. Bye-bye. Amen. Hallelujah.